another episode of Cooking with Kane. Today we're going to do some easy fajitas. Here's our ingredients. And I'm just going to remind you of the marinade that I use for my chicken. So what we're going to need is a tablespoon of soy sauce, tablespoon of corn flour, tablespoon of olive oil, salt and pepper to season. I've cut my chicken into thick strips this time so it fits in the wrap nice and easy. We're going to start off by getting some oil in a pan, turn the heat on so it heats up a little bit, and then we're going to add the chicken. And this is a really important part, we need to separate all the chicken so it cooks evenly. So we're going to leave that cooking for 5 minutes, and then we're going to see what we've got in our fajita kit. So we've got some wraps, we've got some fajita seasoning, and we've got some spicy tomato salsa. I'm going to start by chopping my veggies. I've got some mushrooms. And I've got an onion, just going to take the top and the tail off, peel the skins away, and then I'm going to slice these. So cut your onion in half, and then just almost like mini wedges. And then my red pepper, so I'm just slicing it. You can see I've got a membrane inside of my pepper. It's pretty important to get rid of this because it can be quite bitter. So try and cut that out really carefully and then slice the remaining. So the chicken will need to be cooked for 5 minutes each side. We're just aiming to seal the chicken at this point. So you can see as I'm turning the chicken over, one side is really nice and brown and the other side still needs cooking. So it's important to turn every single piece of chicken in the pan. Half of the seasoning packet. We're going to save the other half of the veggies later. So open up your seasoning packet that you've got in your fajita kit, pour half of it over your chicken, and now we need to get stirring. We need to make sure there's no powder left on the pan. It needs to be all coated in the chicken. So we need to put the chicken in a bowl to one side. This is going to let the chicken rest a little bit, and it also gives us an opportunity to start cooking our veggies and browning them off. So same pan, little bit of oil, put all of your veggies in and start stirring. So once they're browned off, you need to add the rest of the seasoning packet. And also we need to give those a really good stir, so all of the powder, all of the seasoning coats the vegetables. So, back in with the chicken. Give it a good stir. Now, I want you to be the judge of this. I add the whole salsa packet. You can add half if you like and use the rest for your wraps, but I think it gives it a really nice flavor. It makes it quite spicy and it makes it more saucy. And make sure you give it a really good mix. So now with that cooking away, I've got some washed iceberg lettuce here, and you can see I'm shredding it quite finely. My cucumber, just going to cut it lengthways and cut them into half moon shapes. These are going to be really easy to put in my wrap and then wrap it up. And we've got some cheddar cheese. I'm not going to be using the coarse area of my grater, I'm going to be using the fine area of my grater. So you've got to be really careful with here. We don't want to grate any fingernails in there. Be really careful and take your time. And I'm just getting my Philadelphia cheese ready. So this is what our fajita mix should look like. All of the salsa is combined, everything together to make it really saucy and tasty. And the next bit you need to be really careful. I like to microwave my wraps first, maybe about 10 seconds each, and then I get some bamboo tongs, and I'm just going to be putting the wrap on the naked flame on your hob for about 3 seconds each side. Keep on turning it so we get that char grilled effect. It makes the wraps really tasty. So, time to wrap up. I go for cream cheese, cucumber, lettuce, chicken, then my grated cheese. I hope you enjoyed this quick video about fajitas. I've really just adapted the instructions that are on the fajita kit. So you can follow the instructions if you like, or you can follow my recipe. Now, I only serve my fajitas as they are, as wraps. You can serve yours with fries, with wedges. You can make a big, tasty, rainbow, stay safe salad. It's totally up to you. You can add tomatoes, sweet corn, loads of different peppers. You can add radishes. You can add whatever vegetables you've got in your fridge. And for the salad, you can add anything you like as well. So this also works well with corn chicken pieces. So if you want to make it a totally veggie option, then that is good too. Just want to remind you to be really careful if you're going to be using the hob in order to flame grill your wraps. The wraps are going to be fine if you just want to microwave them. They'll go nice and soft so you can wrap your fajitas up well. If you want to make it a little bit crispier, that little bit tastier, make sure you use the right utensils and be safe whilst you're doing it. Thanks for watching this episode of Cooking with Kane. Hope you've enjoyed it. Like I said, really simple, really quick. And if you put a lot of ingredients in there, it can feed the whole family. Like always, missing everyone on up. Please stay safe, keep active. See you next time.